Good evening, everyone, and thank you for coming to the second and final concert of the 14.5 Bonneville Chamber Music Festival. It's very nice to see everyone here on this very special day as well for all of us. So, I'm just going to tell you a little bit what I said yesterday about why is it 14.5 and not 15th, because this is really essentially the 15th year of the Bonneville Chamber Music Festival. Last year we did only one event, and that was only virtual event. And the idea was to then move on to the 15th anniversary of the festival this year. Because of certain uncertainty still, as you can tell, we decided to wait for another year, and just adding two concerts create kind of a group of three concerts in this very troubling past year and a half. That's why it's called 14.5. I was thinking about 14 and a half, but our marketing director advised me to say 14.5. So that's the reason why it's called that way. So next year, we're hoping to do 2 weeks of fully back to normal, probably four or five events, where the plan is to incorporate many more musicians and Weber State colleagues, some of which I can see here. And that is basically the idea behind that. And then two concerts were presented this time. Yesterday we had a very colorful and a concert with lots of arrangements of folk music from around the world. It was fun, and there was jazz, and there was Eastern European folk and Latin American folk, and so it was really special for everybody just to play for you this way, right? Face to face and in the hall. Tonight, however, is a little different, and the idea behind tonight's program was that I had a specific group of people in mind to play together, whom you will hear tonight. And we talked about program after not playing for such a long time, and this is coming from musicians' perspective, not artistic director's perspective, is okay, so what do we want to play? And you could just tell that all of us really just missed playing some great chamber music, classical chamber music, by great composers. So for piano quartet, if you think about, okay, so what would you like to play? Well, let's play Brahms, third piano quartet. Schumann is so beautiful, and all these melodies. Why? Because there's so much contrast and drama. It's just masterpieces for piano quartet. So once that happened, really what you will hear tonight is our effort and years of working on our own and then getting together to collaborate on something that we love and that we give through our performance, what composer tries to communicate to us. And that emotion is what we would like to dedicate tonight, this performance, to the victims of 9/11, because that is what we do as musicians. So in memory of the victims of 9/11, I would like to ask you for a moment of silence. And then let's proceed to the program, thank you. So you will hear, Vedrana will talk a little bit about the pieces, and then you will hear a little bit more about why they're so intricate and so special to us. I invite you to join us next year. Thank you for coming. We're also broadcast live online to everyone in the world over different social media platforms. So probably right now we have maybe 50, 60 more people watching us, maybe 200,000 of people. But thank you for coming, and really, I really appreciate that you're here and that we'll share this with you live. Thank you.
concert tonight. I don't know if we have program notes. Can you not hear me?
I don't think the mic is...
It's on now. Can you hear me now?
Yay.
I did that with my head only. Turn it on. So I'm not sure that we have program notes for tonight, and of course, for those of you who are joining us by live stream, it might be nice to just have a little bit of a context for these two pieces that we're performing for you tonight. Schumann and Brahms are often paired together on programs because they were very close friends, close musical allies, and enjoyed lots of time together and sharing of various almost family-like jokes, and I will tell you a little bit about that and when we get to the Brahms. But with the Schumann piano quartet, Schumann's love story is probably one of the greatest that ever existed that we know of. He and his wife Clara waited for 9 years to be able to get the permission from her father, who was a piano teacher, to marry. And Clara was a very accomplished pianist. She was probably the first woman to have a concertizing career and to perform as a soloist all over Europe. And so Schumann, understandably, was he admired her greatly, her talent, and so he ended up writing a lot of his piano music and chamber music with her in mind to perform. And indeed, when he composed this piano quartet in 1842, it was Clara who gave the premiere. The quartet is also has another little interesting anecdote. It's dedicated to a cellist whose name is Matthew. I'm going to have to look it up. An amateur cellist, I should say. His first job was to be a Russian count. But his second job, Vihorsky, thank you. What had happened is that when the Schumanns went to St. Petersburg in Russia to visit, they were entertained by this person, Vihorsky, Count Vihorsky, who was kind of an interesting character on his own. He studied music in Italy with Luigi Boccherini, who was a well-known music composer and teacher and is still remembered for the contributions he made to the cello repertoire. Vihorsky was a cellist, amateur cellist, I suppose, himself, and Schumann had purportedly been very impressed not only by his hospitality and kindness as a host to Clara and him when they were in St. Petersburg, but he also heard him perform Mendelssohn's cello sonatas. So after their return from St. Petersburg in 1844, the next year, Schumann dedicated the quartet to this friend. Even though the piano part is very prominent, being that he wrote this quartet for Clara to perform, the heart and soul of this piece is really the third movement with its beautiful cello solo, which is also shared later with the viola and violin. And it's really the essence of Schumann's style and a great representation of his love for his wife, Clara Schumann. I hope you enjoy.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
I'm not sure if these lights were on before. Do we have more light now than before? Not clear. Well, we're back for the second half, featuring Brahms's third piano quartet, which he actually started composing in his 20s, right around a time when he met the Schumanns. He showed up one day at the Schumanns' front door with a manuscript of his work and said, "I've been told that you're someone who would be able to help me start my compositional career." And Schumann took a look at this young man's work and was immediately aware that he had just met someone who was going to be a big name in music. And so he developed a very close friendship. Brahms actually lived with the Schumann family for a while and was very helpful as sort of an extra family member to Clara when Schumann became ill. During that time, the Schumanns and the Brahms enjoyed multiple literary references. Schumann was a great admirer and supporter of writers and poets of the time. And he was often inspired by the work of contemporary literature, works of contemporary literature from which he actually drew a couple of different characters that he introduced in his music by means of lyrical melodies contrasted with sort of a more fiery and passionate characters, Eusebius and Floresten. And Brahms was part of this literary reference circle, and as Schumann commemorated his love for his wife Clara in many of the works, he infused them with quotes of her names. For example, in a work, early piano work called Carnival, he actually wrote miniature music miniatures and gave them names of his friends. One of them was Clara, and the melodies, etc. And then he goes back down. And so this falling scale motif became Clara's motif, and you will hear multiple references to Clara's name in Brahms's quartet tonight, which begins with... So those falling, descending few pitches are always references to her name. Another interesting bit that Brahms worked in as he revised this work over and over again, because he was such a perfectionist, he burned a lot of his works that he didn't feel were up to par, and so we are left with only what he considered to be the absolute perfection. So he reworked some of his early youthful works, and this quartet, it was actually the first one that he composed, even though it's numbered 3, but he worked on it over time and eventually came out with this revised version. One thing you might recognize in the last movement is a reference to Beethoven's 5th symphony. Remember this? Right. So here, between the piano and violin. So some of the things to listen for are those little references to either people that Brahms admired or his friends, and of course Clara and Robert Schumann. Thank you so much again for being here with us tonight, and I hope you enjoy the third piano quartet by Brahms.
Just another thank you for coming. It really meant a lot to us to play in front of you, to play in front of live audience, and to be able to dedicate this music to the victims of 9/11. So thank you again, and hope to see you exactly a year from now, just around the Labor Day weekend. We'll have the 15th celebration with full house. Thank you.